Hi everybody, I'm Dave from Tech2Go. Welcome to our The New Norm show. This is our episode number 7. So all are welcome. And just to give some brief about Tech2Go virtual event e-studio, which we have developed in-house to organize the talk show, product presentation, virtual summits, training, coaching, and of course the biggest advantage is live streaming to any possible web browser or even in the Facebook and YouTube. So today my guest for the show will be Mr. Gaurav. He's one of my close friend, and many of you must be knowing him in the travel fraternity. And the speaker for today's show is Pimsri. She is also known to me, my great friend from Hua Hin. And she is the director events of Sheraton Hua Hin. Sheraton Hua Hin, many of you must be knowing. So let's see how they are here, how they feel comfortable today in show. Hi Gaurav, how are you?
Hello Dev Saab, how are you, sir? I'm doing good.
Fantastic. And welcome to our show. And Pimsri, how are you?
Hi, Kundev. I'm good. How are you? I'm doing well.
I'm also fine. Seeing you after many months, I should say, many months. So today, to begin with our 7th episode of this, The New Norm, which is to generally brief about the preparation of different hotels around Thailand, how they are preparing themselves to welcome the guests once the movement starts from different part of the world coming to the Thailand. So this is the time to give the mic to Gaurav, and Gaurav will proceed with today's this talk show.
Thank you, Dev Saab. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to be on the show, and I hope I do justice to this show. So welcome, Khun Pimsri. Welcome to the show. And as we know, you are taking care of two beautiful properties in Hua Hin. Sheraton needs no introduction. And Hua Hin, people are so much well-versed with Thailand. Hua Hin itself is a beautiful destination. It's a beach destination. Very famous amongst Indian travelers. Very famous for Indian weddings, I would say. And but no doubt for the last couple of months, all of us have been, grounded forcefully in the current scenario. But I guess now we are very hopeful that things should improve. And how is now Thailand treating you? How's the market? Is the market showing up for you? What kind of trend is the market, your local domestic market, is being witnessed by you? Please, over to you. I would like to know this brief from your side. Thank you, Pimsri.
Thank you, Khun Gaurav. Thank you for having me today. I'm really excited today also. Regarding the trend or business right now, actually, Thailand, everything nearly back to normal. So everything already open, hotel are open. We has been closed for 2 months from April, and then we just start to reopen in June, and we start to reaping the very good pick up from the domestic traveler, because they everyone would like to travel after lockdown. So we got a lot of pick up, especially on weekend. Every Saturday, Sunday, we are like nearly fully booked. Weekday a little bit slow, but we try to launch a promotion to fill in, and then now we wait, the situation will be even better, and then the international flight open, so then we can receive the overseas guests, and I hope Indian wedding will be back very soon.
Yeah, sure. Indian weddings will be back very soon. I agree with you. And any which ways, Hua Hin is just a couple of hours drive from Bangkok, so you must be getting a lot of weekend traffic. And like you rightly said, you are working on new offers to attract traffic during weekdays. And I'm sure you must be working on good offers, and you will surely launch those offers soon for India market as well. But that's good. That's really, really very nice to hear that business is picking up. So we would like to know something more about your properties. There are two properties which you are taking care of. And if you could brief us, or tell us in brief about those properties, please.
We are managed two property in Hua Hin destination. The first one is Sheraton Hua Hin Resort and Spa Beach. Everyone might already know about this property. We are located.
This property does not need any introduction. It's a very popular property in India, Hua Hin Resort and Spa.
Yeah, just give me, I mean, give a, some brief for some people that maybe not never visit us before. So like we are the family friendly luxury beachfront resort with a low rise architecture. We have a 240 rooms and surrounding with a tropical garden and feature with a very large lagoon shaped swimming pool, which is visit our unique. We also have a variety of indoor and outdoor function spaces for perfect meeting and event, and also definitely for the memorable wedding. I have a short video to present of Sheraton Hua Hin. Let's have a look.
Oh yeah, yeah, please. That was amazing. That was awesome. Awesome. It was really out of the world. And it again, like I said, it's a popular, very popular property. It's awesome. So let's hear something about the second property you had.
Yeah, the Sheraton Hua Hin Family Villa is another property that's away from Hua Hin Town, around 32 minutes. This destination is like the facility is ready for the romantic couple getaway. Each of our 53 villas, we have a private swimming pool, sunken outdoor bathtub, and breathtaking view from the ocean for your complete privacy. Let's have a look for a short video.
Yeah, sure, please. Oh, again, a very, very stunning property. It's a very luxurious property as well. And this is a perfect, getaway for couples. Beautiful. I'm speechless. Ultimately, it's a very, very lovely property. Thank you very much for this showcase. So coming back to our chat, we also hope and pray that the market opens up for India soon. And I believe with the commercial flights, shall be opened very soon. But since I'm representing the Indian travel fraternity here, so I have a few questions from my travel agent friends. So just to understand how you are controlling the current scenario and what would be your future plans to control the situations. So if you would agree, let me start with my first question, please.
Sure.
Thank you very much. So I want to understand, what are your plans when there is a guest who's checking in, is found with any kind of, you know, symptoms for the current medical condition? So how are you planning to handle that particular so-called health risk if a client or if a guest is found symptomatic when at the time of the check-in? So what are your plans to handle that?
So please. When the guests arriving to the hotel, at the entry point, we have a body temperature check for all the guests who enter to the hotel. Those who have a temperature at 38 degrees Celsius will be subject to secondary screening. And for those who confirm to have a temperature at 30 degrees Celsius or higher, or they have other related symptoms, they will be encouraged to contact the health authority. And extensive crisis communication plan are in place so that appropriate quarantine procedure will, with the cleaning protocol, will be implemented.
Oh, that's wonderful. That's wonderful. This seems that you guys are well prepared with all the equipments and the guidelines to control anything just at the point of entry. That's impressive. But so now coming, going forward to the next question, how are you controlling your F&B outlets, your food and beverage outlets like a coffee shop, a bar or a restaurant, all day dining? So what are the guidelines you're following that? What kind of social distancing norms and the other hygiene procedures or measures, please? We would like to understand that as well.
We strictly follow through the Marriott International reinforcement on appropriate hygiene standard. Marriott have developed the cleaning protocol throughout each step of our gate and every physical space in the hotel. I would like to highlight some guidelines for restaurant and outlet, which including like the same as the check-in, that we have the temperature check at the entry point at each restaurant. We also reduce the seating area and practice social distancing between each station. We replace the guest-facing service utensil with the new utensil every 30 minutes. Also sanitize service station and buffet line area, including the equipment, every 30 minutes too. We encourage the guests to order a la carte, book breakfast, lunch, or grab and go option. And associate will be the one who serve all the food and beverage, and we do not allow the guests to touch or to do the guest service. We use the sneak guard to cover and protect our food from contamination. Associate also should sanitize their hand between guests and after handling cash or credit card and identification. This is like, there will be a lot of guidelines to follow, and these are only some highlight protocol. This is to ensure that the well-being of our guests is our top priority.
Oh, that's good. That's really very nice. And I guess going forward, a la carte would be the solution, at least for some time. And, you know, buffet would definitely take a back step for some time. And I guess one of the best USPs, what I could make out from your brief, is that you are changing the utensils after every 30 minutes. That would really make the difference. So hats off to you. If this is the plan, then definitely people would have no trouble in staying at your properties. So going forward to the next question is, every hotel has one thing, which is an elevator, which is a lift, and it's being used by all the guests. It is being used frequently by the public. So what are your plans to sanitize those, sanitize the lift buttons when it is being pressed every time by the guests? So how do you plan to control that particular situation, please?
We have set the schedule of cleaning and disinfecting at least every 2 hours, all depend on volume required, like such as during the weekend that we have very high occupancy and many guests using the lift all the time. So we'll set up the more frequent time to cleaning and disinfecting the lift button. And we also put the alcohol gel in front of the lift, like to give all the guests to can wash the hand before enter to the lift also.
Oh, that's wonderful. So you guys are sanitizing the lift buttons after every 2 hours, plus you're making the guests wash their hands. So you are not leaving any stone unturned to maintain hygiene standard. That's really very, very impressive again. So going forward to the next question is, what are your plans to treat the check-in luggage which comes along with the guests. So how is that luggage, or how would that luggage be treated? What kind of measures would you take to treat that luggage which comes along with the check-in guests, please?
Yeah, as per the protocol, the SOCA should wear the glove when they handling luggage, and we need to disinfect luggage storage room and mop the floor every 2 hours or so. And also between the ship, we need to clean the storage room. Mm-hmm.
So you're cleaning the service room after every few hours, thus ensuring that all the hygiene standards are being maintained. That's wonderful. Kudos. So going forward to the next question is, now how the check-in guests, the guests who are already staying in the hotel, how are they assured that the housekeeping staff is also, you know, clinically up to the mark, medically up to the mark? So what kind of measures is the hotel or the property taking to that, please?
Our priority is the keeping hotel associate and hotel guests healthy, right? So similarly to the hotel guests, we have the body temperature check at the entry point, not only for housekeeping staff, but we also check for all associates before entering to work. Those who confirm that have like very high temperature, they will be denied entry and will be direct to appropriate medical care, or we send them to hospital. And we also inform the associate that if they are feeling sick, they are encouraged to stay home. Those exhibiting symptoms will be required to self-isolate from one set of symptoms and meet the public health criteria before return to work. All associates who come to work will need to wear the face covering, face shield or face mask as a part of their uniform. So they will be required to be aware and follow the personal hygiene, physical distancing and personal protective equipment in compliance of the all local public health guidance. And we also educate the associate on the proper way to wear, to handle, to dispose of personal protective equipment, as well as the appropriate way to wash the hand, to sneeze, and also avoid touching their face. We educate them also.
So that's nice. So you guys are ensuring that proper training sessions are given to all the employee or the staff of the hotel in terms of how to wash their hands, maintain social distancing. And now going forward, like you said, probably the definition of uniform is changing. Now uniform would consist of a mask, of a shield. So yes, that's the way forward. And very nice to say, very, very nice to see that you are taking all possible measures to control the scenario, and definitely it will definitely surely pay us in the long run. So going forward to the next question is, so if a guest is found exhibiting the symptoms, if a guest who's already staying with you, a resident guest, he's staying with you and he's found exhibiting system, so what kind of medical assistance would be provided by the property? Immediate first aid or immediate medical assistance? What kind of medical assistance would be provided to the guest by the property, please?
We actually don't have the nurse or the doctor in-house. We only have the set of first aid to stand by. So in case of they feel they need the medical assistance, we will contact directly to the hospital, which we have the doctor on call, and we contact with the hospital nearby so that we can contact the hospital within 24 hours. I mean, all the time in 24 hours, just 5-10 minutes, they will arrive the hotel, the hospital.
Oh, wonderful. So a doctor can be, a doctor is just a call away. So the hotel staff, yes, will assist and call the doctor, and this service is available 24/7. And plus you already have a first aid kit stationed in the hotel to provide immediate relief. Oh, that's wonderful. You guys are really, really on top of it. That's quite impressive. But now going forward to the next question is, I guess during these couple of months, people have become more health conscious. That's what I feel. They've become more diet conscious due to, you know, change in the immune system. So is there any kind of special changes in the menu which the hotel is planning to get in terms of the hygiene, in terms of immune, in terms of nutrition value? Any changes in the menu specifically, please?
We actually did not change in the menu item, but we follow the hygiene protocol and we change with the new normal style setup or something concerned with the hygiene thing, like such as the breakfast. We will do live station rather than in hot dishes and or serve in a small portion in the buffet line. So like start to slowly refill, not to put the food and then left over for a long time. And we use the snake card to cover or protect the food. And like what I said, the associate should be the one who serve the food. And then we do not allow the guests to touch the buffet or to do the self-service. And we encourage the a la carte, box breakfast or grab and go option. However, we are on process to implement like the digital menu. This is part of Marriott program also that we are implementing. This is on process so that guests can ordering food via QR code, which is very good.
So definitely if a digital menu is introduced, that would be a game changer, no doubt about it. And like you're saying that self-service by the guest would be discouraged, that is another very 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 good step to take care of the hygiene standards. That's really impressive again. So going forward to the next question is, so the common areas like the lobby, the foyer, and your all-day dining, which is the coffee shop. So do you have a set schedule to disinfect these areas? At what regular intervals would these areas would be sanitized and disinfected? At least the common areas. So do you have any set schedule for this, please?
Yeah, the guest impression is always very important, and their impression is affect how confident they feel about the cleanliness of the hotel and the guest room. If the hotel common area or public spaces are not perfectly clean, the guest may think that their room might not clean either. So we really pay attention on the all common areas such as like lobby, elevator, business center, spa, pool, or fitness center. We really pay attention. So we provide the related signage and material describing good health practicing our public area. Signage will be posted to remind the guests of physical distancing guidelines and hygiene practice to prevent the spread of disease. In the certain areas, such as the arrival queue or gathering area, will be marked with the signage and, if necessary, one-way guest traffic flow indicate. And based on the volume of use, the public space requires constant attention to ensure they kept clean and disinfect. So we will clean and disinfect at least every 2 hours. And when where is higher use, we also do quite more often. And we also focus on like high touch areas such as doorknob, handrail, elevator button, or entrance, bell stand, a public bathroom. This is we are very focused, and we train all associates for knowledge about the product to use for cleaning and disinfecting. So we always remember that the clean hotel is a trusted hotel. So we need to make sure that the guests confident when they are stay at the hotel.
So completely agree. Like you rightly said, if the guest finds that the public areas are not clean, he would not rather like to stay in the hotel. And like you said, that you have already are planning to have a schedule to clean the or disinfect the public areas after every 2 hours, including the handrails and the common areas. So this is very, very impressive again. And I'm sure the Sheraton as a brand will definitely live up to it. So that's wonderful. Okay, going forward to the next question is, again, now with the new normal, I would say, or the new norm, right? So what would be the guideline for the banqueting facilities in terms of, you know, how many people can attend a particular function, and what would be the seating plan for any function, and what is the maximum capacity you are now allowed to, as per the new guidelines, what is the new capacity you're allowed to book, along with any kind of seating plan as per the guideline? So could you throw some light on that, please?
Yeah, talking about the banquet facility and capacity, one of our resort unique selling point is spaces function room and an outdoor function space. So where we would definitely enable us to apply the application on the new normal of the social distancing policy. Having said that, the well-being of our guests is our top priority, so that we could definitely calculate the number of participants per square meter and strictly follow through the instruction of the local authority. As such, we could safely and comfortable to accommodate up to 210 people banquet set up, and the number could be adjusted based on government guidance over such a particular time. So I also have the presentation in a video about the meeting room social distancing set up to show how many seats in each function room. Let's have a look.
Please, please.
รบกวนลงทะเบียนครับขออนุญาตตรวจวัดไข้ครับขออนุญาตติดสติ๊กเกอร์ครับ
That was really, really very impressive and nice. So I personally, if you ask me, I really like the signage that maintain a 2 meters distance, and you know, everybody is wearing the mask. All the associates are wearing the mask, and even the dinner buffet is being served by the associate. So self-service is being discouraged, like you rightly said. And obviously, you are maintaining proper 2 meters of distance, even in terms of banqueting or cluster style of seating. So that's very impressive, and I guess going forward, at least for some time, we're gonna follow this new normal scenario. And I wish you all the best for the season, or for the season, upcoming season, I would say. So going forward with the next question, so In case if any of the guests is found to be affected, then what kind of measures are you taking to protect the other guests of the hotel? So if a particular guest is affected, then what kind of measures would you, you know, what kind of measures the hotel would take to ensure safety and protection of the other resident guests of the hotel? Please.
Okay. In case of we have the confirmed case or we have the suspect case of the disinfect, so this effect, so that guest room will be removed from the service and to undergo a specific cleaning protocol. The guest room will not be able to return to service until the room has been disinfected and consistent with the guidance issued by local authority. Similar recovery protocol addressed to all public space, associate office, and the working area. We need to follow
that. Oh, that's again good. So you obviously, the hotel tends to follow the guidelines issued by the local authorities, and which are actually very, very, very important in the current scenario. So thank you very much, Pimsiri. I guess this is the few points which our travel agents from India had. And I guess you've been very, very kind to come on the show. And thank you very much for all the detailed showcasing and briefing. And we are very much, I would say we are very much, we are sure that you would follow all the guidelines and the safety standards and hygiene standards. And soon India would be showcasing or witnessing the Thailand hospitality once again. Thank you very much for coming on the show. Swadhi Kaap again. Kapun Kaap.
Thank you, Kunkarav. And I also want to thank you, TAT and Tech2Go, for having me here today in this very good program. And we really look forward to welcome you in Hua Hin soon, after everything
soon.
Is back to normal.
Soon. Yeah. We are also hoping and praying the same. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.